Okay, so let's continue and see what is an information system. So in the previous video, we have seen data, information and knowledge. So an information system is actually a computerized system composed of people, hardware, software and procedures that work together to collect and store data and process it in such a way that we get information that we can use to take decisions and create knowledge. So as we've seen in the previous video, processing data consists of collecting it, storing it, organizing it, contextualizing it, sorting it, filtering it, these type of things, do calculations, everything in order to get information. So let's look at the different parts that an information system is composed of. So first we have hardware. Hardware in an information system is any physical component that can be touched or seen, or basically any physical component of a computerized system that you can break. It includes, for example, the computer, which has this central processing unit that processes and does all the calculations. It consists of a monitor that you can use to display the information that you have processed from the data. You have a keyboard that permits to input data into the system. A printer, for example, that allows you to print. A storage services that can store data like hard disk or flash drives, USB sticks. And you have communication devices, like for example, you can maybe connect your mobile or your tablet or the modems that are connected to the system. So this is all hardware. It can break. You can touch it and you can see it. So the other component is data, obviously, because this is an information system and the data is the foundation of all the information that we can obtain. And it are the facts, the raw and unprocessed facts that you use to get information. This data is normally stored in databases, and that is just a way of storing data on a disk in a form that is readable by the machine. So we have hardware, we have data, the next component is the software. So software, compared to hardware, is something you cannot see. You cannot touch and you cannot break it physically. So these are the computer programs. Computer programs are machine-readable instructions that give instructions to the circuitry of the hardware in order to indicate what it should do to process the data and get useful information out of it. So as a small example we can see here on the slide, imagine that we have a web store where we sell products and we want to provide a discount to customers that buy something above $100. So we say, okay, we obtain the price of the product from the database. Then we take that price and we process it in such a way to find out whether it's more than $100. And if it is, we give the client a discount. So this is, at a very high level, some type of software procedure that indicates to the computer what it should do in order to process data and give us information. So the final component is people. People are always needed because if nobody is operating the system is not really useful. But these are not only the users, it's also other people that we need in order to operate the system. So for example, people that administrate the computers, that install the software and do the updates. We also need people to maintain and input the data, because if nobody maintains and inputs the data, there is no data to process information from. And obviously also support the network of computer. If a computer breaks, it should be fixed. So this is a whole team of people that we need in order to make an information system work. And finally, the last component of an information system are the procedures. The procedures actually describe how this hardware, the software, the databases and the data and the people should work together in order to process the information and produce the preferred output. So this is, for example, one of the procedures is that if we know that the price is above $100, then the customer gets a discount. This is a very tiny example of a procedure that we can use and describes how we use the hardware, the software, the data and the people in order to obtain information. In the next video, we will see lifecycle concepts and how we can develop information systems.